I thought about that, but I thought after opening the mouth wide, you would have to
have a bit of a stick. Yeah, as you would, Wanda, and you were on that same wavelength. We're on a score of 3, which is pretty good, Megan. Jane, what did you do? Did you spit out, rinse, go to the waiting room? Oh, drill! Oh, I see. Early on in the night. Oh, that's good. That's interesting. Congratulations. Megan, that's 3. When we come back, you can have a shot at it. Derek playing Blankety Blanks and Steve Jacobs could be knocking on your door. Oh, thank you. Welcome back. We're playing Blankety Blanks. As you can see, Megan is on 3, and now it's Derek's turn to... Oh, don't do that. Derek's turn, Hamana, to play. A new law has been passed in the North Pole. It's now illegal to blank a penguin. Derek, ponder that thought. It's now illegal to blank a penguin in the North Pole after this new law has been passed. Could be anything, couldn't it, Larry? Really, blanking a penguin? I mean, you know, because they get up to all sorts of things, those penguins, don't they?
They do.
Especially up there at the pole.
They're bored with themselves.
What would you do up a pole?
Well, it's just ice and snow and...
Nothing.
You can fish.
You
like fishing? I like the little fairy penguins.
Do you? They're cute, aren't they? And they taste good with potato and salad. Oh. Good. Okay, sorry, I didn't say that. We're all locked in. A new law has just been passed in the North Pole. It's now illegal to blank a penguin.
Oh, I think stuff a penguin, Shane.
That's not bad, considering. Larry, a new law has been passed in the North Pole. It's now illegal to blank a penguin.
Sort of sick man would say stuff a penguin.
You tell me what sort of sick man would say.
Oh.
I don't know what sort of sick guy is.
That is a match. Rhonda, are you sick?
No, well, no. But I was going up. I was going up the Eskimo path. You know how they.
Rub nose and snog. Snog. Illegal to snog one?
Yeah, snog one.
Oh, I see.
As you would.
As you would. You have a snog one, Marty?
No, I haven't snogged one, but actually I was up the North Pole catching polar bears.
Oh, were you?
Tough gig, because what you do, right, catch a polar bear, you cut a hole in the ice, you sprinkle peas all around it, right, and then when the polar bear comes up for a pee, you kick him in the ice hole.
Goose a penguin. That's funny. Not a match. Doesn't matter. Got one. Annie Rigby, can we help here?
I'd love to. I think I can. They are an endangered species, so it is illegal to kill them.
No, I don't think that's a match. There is a kind of difference between a quick stuff and a kill. A new law has just been passed, Dermot, in the North Pole. It's now illegal to blank a penguin. What do you think while Derek's on 1?
I'd love to help Derek out, but I just was thinking a little bit violent. A kickboxer.
You're mad. Kickboxer penguin.
Oh, I don't know.
You've got to catch him first. Jane, what were you doing to that poor little penguin?
I'm on the wrong game.
You?
I got no idea.
Come on down! Oh, right.
I thought that was a double entendre.
Oh, it'd be tricky to stay on. Especially when they buck those penguins, they go mad. You're on 1, you're on 3. We've got a game on our hands. Steve Jacobs has got a grand in the hand. A friend of a friend, they're about to knock on a door. Steve, come in.
Yee-haw, Shane. We're at the home of line dancing fan Diane O'Dwyer. And this is her mother, Beryl, who's dobbed her in. So, Beryl, what does Diane do for a living?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Good. She's a single mum.
And so I guess you could use the $1,000 then.
Oh, my word, she could.
Okay. Hello.
Surprise.
Diane O'Dwyer, how are you? Spankin' Steve Jacobs here. You've been a naughty girl, haven't you? Come on, bend over. Just joking, your mum Beryl has dobbed you in to play Blankety Blanks and win $1,000. Would you like to play? Okay, come on, let's round on up. Into the lounge room here, there we go. Right over here. All right, Diane, are you a bit of a line dancing fan?
I was.
Yeah. Now, it's very easy to win on this show. I believe you've been on The Price is Right. What did you have to do on that program?
I had to do the, the race game.
Right, well, it's a lot easier on this show. All you have to do is take this whip, there you go, and show us one of your big cracks. There we go. Just point it right over there. Go for the cameraman right over there. It's okay. He's insured. Nice and gentle. Just down low there. Nice and low. There we go. All right, just... Oh! That's okay, you can always adopt. Now, Shane Bourne is in the studio and he has details on how you can win this $1,000.
That is a throbber of a crack. I haven't seen... But now, I'll tell you, before I read the question, let me tell you, we have six celebrities here. All you've got to do is match a blank in a question with one of them that you choose, and you could be $1,000. Richard, let me tell you who's here. We have Larry Emder, Rhonda Birchmore, oh, Marty Fields, Annie Rigby, Dermot Brereton, and Jane Turner. Who would you like?
Dermy.
Dermy. Okay. Here's a question, Dermy. Yeah. Karen Perkins said, I don't mind them saying I swim like a fish, just as long as they don't say I blank like one. There you go, Dermy. Karen Perkins said, I don't mind them saying I swim like a fish just as long as they don't say I blank like one. I think that's a pretty good answer, actually. Okay, so let's just go to the... Lock it in.
Lock it in? Oh, I have to do that first. Sorry, I thought okay. I was the only one playing.
That's all right. Steve, is it Diane we're playing with out there?
Yes, yeah. Diane.
Right, the cracker. Okay. Karen Perkins said, this is for a grand, I don't mind them saying I swim like a fish just as long as they don't say I blank like one. What do you reckon?
Smell.
Mm. Well, that's not a bad answer, actually. Let's see. Dermy? You got smell?
I was thinking along the lines of drink like a fish.
Oh, well, bad luck. Bad luck. That is a reasonable answer.
Bad luck. No. Listen, as a consolation prize, Diane, you get this wonderful Blankety Blanks T-shirt and cap from Blue Gum Products, and also the Blankety Blanks watch from Hourglass Jewelers. Beryl, you'll have to take that off because you have to give that to Diane, and you get absolutely nothing. Shane, it's back to you.
Thanks, Steve. Beautiful. Look, when we come back, Megan and Derek are going to be playing Blankety Blanks 3-on-1, and it's double points, could be $5,000. So come back while we play Blankety Blanks. Good game, isn't it? Playing Blankety Blanks, we're up to the double points, very close to the $5,000. Derek's on one and Megan is on three. Now, we're going to write our answers down this time. Celebrities, listen up here, and contestants, we're going to write them down simultaneously. And I'll tell you what, just so there's no shenanigans, there, the cone of silence, the breadboard of doom. Oh, there's the organ. I don't know why I do that. Oh, two young lovers. Two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. I don't know why they were doing that. It must be the garlic. They gazed at the Mona Lisa. But he knew it was true love when she kissed him under the... blank. There we go. Write your answers down. Shouldn't have bothered. Man. Write them down quickly, because I just wasted 5 minutes doing the mouth acting. I'll read it again for you, Jane. Two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. They gazed at the Mona Lisa, but he knew it was true love, but she kissed him under the blank. You locked in, Annie Rigby? Are you having fun? Are you having as much fun as you did when you played a nude nun on Chances?
I'm having more fun now.
Good to hear you. Good to hear you kick the habit. Kick the habit!
I've picked up a few since then, actually.
You've picked up a few habits, have you? You got a job in the monastery. Oh, I'll get that one. Okay. You can kiss a nun once, you can kiss a nun twice, but never get into the habit. An old gag. Two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. They gazed at the Mona Lisa, but he knew it was true love when she kissed him under the blank. Let's have a look at your answers. Megan, you have written what? Eiffel Tower. Eiffel Tower. Okay, now the way we play here, we pick top or bottom. Because you're on one, you can pick whether you want to play with the top row or the bottom row of celebrities. Derek, up to you.
Top row.
Top row. Okay, now I think you need a match to be in the game because Megan's on three. Larry, two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. They go to the Mona Lisa, but he knew it was true love when she kissed him under the blanks. Eiffel Tower. Well, you're in the game. You're in the game. This could be very, very interesting, I reckon. Rhonda, did you have Eiffel Tower?
I'd be getting excited in your pants, look.
Oh! He's rocking. The top row's doing very well for you. What have you got, Marty?
I was going to say she kissed him under the dashboard, but I said Eiffel Tower.
Very nice and glory, too. Well done. Okay, you're on seven. So we need at least two matches, I think. I'll read it again for you. Two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. They go to the Mona Lisa, but he knew it was true love when she kissed him under the blank. You've got the bottom, which is very handy. Annie, what have you got?
Something for Megan.
Eiffel Tower. We're rocking. Dermot, we need this for a tie at this point in time. What were your young lovers up to? Who kissed who where?
Well, I think Megan is going to like me.
I think, oh yes. Do you realise what's happened? We are on even here, 7-all. It's completely up to you. I'm not going to make you nervous, Jane. Completely up to you as to who wins this game. Let me read it again. Two young lovers, could be $5,000 for one of these lucky people. Two young lovers were in Paris. They walked hand in hand along the Seine. They goes to the Mona Lisa, but he knew it was true love when she kissed him under the blank. What have you got?
Lucky there's only one landmark in Paris, isn't it?
Aha! Yes, we have a winner. Well done, Jane. That is a match. Terrific. Wasn't that fun?
That was great.
It was. Now, you don't go home empty-handed, Derek. Oh, no. You go home with this.
CD stereo sound wherever you may blank. This CD player not only has an AM/FM tuner and twin cassette deck, it's also fully portable. It's from Sharp and Blankety Blanks.
Good on you, Derek. We've enjoyed your company. See you next time. Wave goodbye to Derek. Folks, celebrities and blankers, I'll tell you what, we're running out of time. Do you want to play for $5,000?
Yes!
Let's do that. Come back. We'll do that in a minute right here on Blankety Blanks.